Well, you guys have been struggling for years, playing all around here, and you're about to hit the big time now with this recording contract. What are we going to see? A Hooters victory tour now in the making?
It's on its way. Yeah. You know, hopefully, it starts small, but it is building in a nice way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's it look like? I mean, what's the difference? Struggling for a long time and now this. What's it feel like?
Well, it's still struggling. You always struggle, and the more successful you are, I think the more you have to keep struggling.
You started out appealing to an older crowd. You were playing in a lot of taverns, some universities, but over this summer you've really appealed to the high school group.
Yeah. That's a great change for us too, because there's a we were getting a lot of airplay on the radio stations, but the kids couldn't get into the clubs to see us, you know, that were under 21. So in the last year especially, we played a lot of schools that were a little hesitant to have shows. They didn't know what they were getting into, but it's worked out great, and that's a great audience for the band, and the shows have been terrific.
How would you describe your music?
We'd rather leave that to someone else to do. Yeah. There are enough critics out there who are anxious to do that.
Is it going to be changing at all with this new recording contract, or pretty much the same?
Well, it's always changing.
Yeah.
I think it's just kind of continuing along its upward climb.
Zombies we played since our very first gig, and we used to open up in bars with it. We would do it first when there were like two people sitting at the bar and get it out of the way because it was this weird song. But there's something about it that we always liked, but it just kind of held in the background. And then the first real break for us, especially on the radio, was doing a live radio concert from Emerald City, which was one of the late great clubs of this area. And out of that concert, people started requesting All You Zombies, and MMR was playing it, and there was a live version which we eventually released, and it was a case of popular demand, like people saying, hey, we want this song. And we really didn't know, you know, it was just one of those kind of quirky little songs that we wrote. And then when we got in the studio, the next step was Rick Chertoff also giving some outside influence and saying, listen, we, you know, this song really has potential.
Hey everybody, welcome to another classic album deep dive as part of my ongoing series. I'm taking a little break from my Monkees deep dive series. And today I'm going to be talking about one of my favorite albums from the 1980s, an absolute gem of an album from 1985. The Hooters, Nervous Night. Now, I have to confess, I got the idea for this episode from my friend Aaron Mutha Alamer on one of his recent Tipsy Tuesdays. He was playing this album, and it was one of those albums that I still listen to, even though it's been some 30-some-odd years since the album came out. I loved this album when it was released. I had it on cassette back in the day, and I played this till the tape wore out. Just listened to it on my Walkman to and from school, out and around. I tended to walk everywhere, so I always had that playing. This is the CD version of the album, but there's just something about this album that is timeless. And I know it sounds weird for an album from 1985, but there are just so many great songs on this album. And I think one of the reasons why people still aren't talking about it, aside from myself and a few other select people, it doesn't really fit in any genre. It's not new wave. It's not hard rock. I wouldn't call it alternative rock. It's not Americana. It's not, you know, synth pop. I don't know how you would classify it exactly. And maybe that's one of the reasons why it hasn't endured like some other, even like The Outfield. You still hear people talk about The Outfield albums. And I was also listening to The Outfield's first album around 1985. But I really just love this album. And so I'm going to do a little bit of a deep dive today, just because the band's not tremendously popular. It's hard to find a lot of info and video for this particular band, but I did my best. But anyway, The Hooters hailed from Philadelphia. They got their start around 1980. They played some local clubs, and they took their name from the melodica, which kind of gave them their trademark sound. It looks a little bit like a guitar, but you blow into it, and it looks sort of like a keyboard, a weird-shaped instrument. But nonetheless, that is what gave them their distinct sound. But even if they didn't have that, the songs on this record are still very finely crafted. They've got great melodies. I love that you've got the dual vocals from Rob Hyman and Eric Bazillion, who were the chief. They were kind of like Tears for Fears, if you will. It was the two of them, and then who gives a crap who else was in the band? It really doesn't matter. But those were the two guys who were with the band, and they're still with them today, and they're still around playing live if you ever, I don't know if they've ever come around this way or not, but I tend to think they're still not popular enough that they're going to draw a huge crowd. But nonetheless, what I did not know about the Hooters is, first of all, they released their first album. I thought Nervous Night was their first album. Turns out it was not. They had an album called Amore, which was released in 1983. They were asked to write, arrange, and perform on Cyndi Lauper's amazing first album, She's So Unusual. I had no idea, but they sure as hell did. And so after that, they actually, some of the songs on their first album, they reworked for the Nervous Night album, Blood from a Stone, All You Zombies. And so some of the stuff on here appeared on their first release, Amore, but it doesn't really matter. They weren't the first band to, Whitesnake, anybody, kind of rework, repurpose songs from a previous album. But anyway, it was released on May 6th, 1985, and only got as far as number 12. So that's still not a bad showing from, you know, just kind of a bar band from Philadelphia. But there were numerous hits that were on MTV, All You Zombies, And We Dance, Day by Day, Where Do the Children Go? So this album was chock full of hits. So they were not one hit wonder. One album wonder? Yeah, they probably were, but still. So anyway, let's get into the songs on this magnificent album. So it opens up with the mega hit. I don't know that it was a mega hit, but And We Danced, which I love it. And that melodica, again, there's a melodica, there's even a mandolin, so many different instruments that are all over this particular record. But And We Dance is a great up-tempo rocker, heavy rocker, but you've got the melodica, you've got some mandolin, a lot of mandolin. Now that I think about it, there's a lot of mandolin on these songs, but you know, it doesn't matter. It gives them their identity, and it kind of set them apart from some of their contemporaries back in the 1980s. And that's what I love about this music, is it's so unique. It really stands apart from the other stuff that you were hearing on the radio in 1985. You know, Bryan Adams and Genesis and stuff like that. So anyway, And We Danced, great song. And then Day by Day, which is another earworm, fantastic, great pop rock hit on here. Got a great verse, great chorus, great vocals, everything about it. It's so up-tempo, it's so happy, it's so exuberant. You can't help but be in a great mood when you hear this. Now, I like depressing music as much as the next guy, but this record is nothing but great, uplifting, very cool music to listen to. Day by Day is just a great, great single. Great video on MTV, which I'm not allowed to show. Then we have another MTV hit. This was the first video by the Hooters that I remember seeing on MTV. And again, it was very weird because it's very moody. It's very atmospheric. It's very cinematic. It's so unlike anything you would expect as a single, particularly in the 1980s, where you had a lot of quirky, unusual songs that did make it onto the radio. But still, even with All You Zombies, got some biblical themes that they're working with, some biblical imagery, some stories from the Old Testament. that they're talking about here. But it's very sparse. It's got great guitar work. And like I said, it's very moody. And it's just one of those songs that I could listen to over and over and not get tired of. Then we have the first, which was not on MTV, Don't Take My Car Out Tonight, which I love. They use the melodica like a horn on this. I love the opening drum beat and the wah, 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 wah. And it's cool, you know, I love the verses, and then you get into a hard rocking chorus. Very cool song, absolutely love it. And I love how they are able to just get so many different textures and noises on each, and I would say noise, but you know what I'm saying, just different textures and different sounds. Anyway, Don't Take My Car Out Tonight, again, is an up-tempo, kind of we're back to the up-tempo song. Could have been a single. I mean, honestly, all these songs are good enough to have been singles on the radio. Had to have been hard picking the ones that they were going to make videos for and release, because these are all great. One thing that I didn't realize, because it's on the cassette and it's on the CD, is the title track, Nervous Night, doesn't appear on the vinyl. Why? Why? You tell me they couldn't fit it on here? I mean, side one, I mean, I guess All You Zombies is a little bit longer, but it doesn't strike me that side one is that much longer than side two, but what do I know? Anyway, Nervous Night, if you have the cassette or if you have the CD, kind of a bouncy little track, a little slower on the tempo, but I still like it. It's a story song. I do enjoy it. And a nice way to wind down side one. Side two starts off with Hanging on a Heartbeat, which is sort of a, you know, insubstantial, up-tempo rocker. And it's a little light on the rock. It's more kind of pop, almost, I don't want to say bubblegum pop, but it's, you know, pretty lightweight. I don't mind it. I do like it. But, you know, in terms of strong songs on this record, not the strongest showing on this album, but I do still like it. Then we have Where Do the Children Go with Patti Smyth from Scandal, who is assisting on the vocals. She's sharing vocals on this, doing some backup vocals. Love that one too. It's a little bit anthemic. And I think that was kind of like the style back in the day, was if you want to have a hit, pull in a female singer to either do backup or share lead vocals, which, you know, is fine. Worked for the Hooters. I think this was a great song. Got some play on MTV. Then South Ferry Road, which is another hard driving rocker, a great song to drive to. If you're on the road, this is a great, this was at least for me back in the day, put this into my car cassette player and, you know, hit the highway. Great, great song. Love that one. My favorite song on this album, and I don't know why, it just always hit me. I love She Comes in Colors, because right out of the gate, well, number one, you've got like this farfisa kind of an organ through it, which I absolutely love. I love the lyrical, you know, She Comes in Colors, which reminds me of She's a Rainbow, the Rolling Stones song. The verses are very moody, very kind of cool, kind of sparse. The verses are, and then in the chorus, it just kicks it up. You got the organ playing. Whoa, 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 whoa. My love, she comes in colors. You can't tell her from the clothes she wears. Just a cool, cool song. That melody just sticks in your head. And then Blood from a Stone, which is another very cool song. I like it. It's almost like a little folk pop, I guess, if you want to call it something, but great way to wind down the album. Love that one. It's just solid all the way through. And like I say, I listened to it today. To me, it still sounds fresh. I still get enjoyment out of it. And I'm glad there are other people out there like Aaron who appreciate this album as much as I do. So anyway, that's my take on the album. I had to throw it out there. Yes, it's a classic album. Don't try to convince me that it's not. But I really love this album. So anyway, let me know what you think of the album. If you watched, if you remember it, if you're familiar with any of the songs, if you own the album still, I'm always impressed when somebody pulls this out and shows me that they actually have a copy. But anyway, that's all for me. Take care.